Good morning, children. In previous class, we had seen the classification of matter. Also, in detail, we have studied the what is pure substances and how they are classified. In today's class, we will learn what is mixture and how they are classified. Let us see what is mixture. A mixture is that form of matter in which two or more components or constituents are mixed in any proportion. Here, mixture, it is a form of matter in which two or more components or constituents is mixed in any proportion. Children, in previous class, we had learned the compounds. What is compound? Compound, it is a mixture of two or more components, and these two or more components mixed in fixed proportion. But in mixture, these components are mixed in any proportion. There is no fixed proportion. They are mixed in any proportion or in any ratio. Such kind of mixture is known as just mixture. But if a mixture in which the components are mixed in a fixed ratio, then such mixture is known as compound. Okay. Now we will see examples for mixture. Sugar solution. It is an example for mixture. Here, sugar is one component and water is another component. When sugar is dissolved in water, we'll get sugar solution. Here, component or constituent may be elements or atoms or molecules. Okay. Here, next example is salt solution. Here, salt is one component and water is another component. When salt is dissolved in water, we'll get the sugar solution. Sugar solution is a mixture of salt and water. Next example is water in alcohol. Water is one component and alcohol is another component. It is a mixture of water and alcohol. Mixture of salt and sugar. Okay. This mixture contains two components, salt and sugar. Air is also an example for mixture because air contains mixture of gases like oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, etc. So air is a mixture because air consists of number of gases. Next is oil in water. When oil is mixed with water, we'll get a mixture. Okay, it is an example for the mixture. Oil is one component and water is another component. Next, mixture of grains and stones. Okay, grain is one component and stone is another component. Okay, mixture of grains and mud. Mud is one component and this grain is another component. Okay, here they are mixed. So, it is an example for the mixture. Now, we will see how mixture is classified. Mixture is classified into two classes, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. On the basis of how two components are mixing and after mixing and what kind of mixture they are forming. On that basis, this mixture is classified into homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. First, we will see what is homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous. Homo means same. Okay. Or uniform. See here, a mixture in which different components or constituents mixed uniformly is known as homogeneous mixture. The mixture in which components or constituents are mixed uniformly, then Such kind of mixture is known as homogeneous mixture. Examples for the homogeneous mixture: sugar solution. Okay, when sugar is dissolved in water, childrens, in a glass we will take water. To that, if we add sugar, after some time, what happens? All sugar crystals are dissolved, and they are distributed uniformly throughout the water. Whenever we see that glass, we'll see we observe only water, but we do not see any sugar crystals. So here, sugar crystals are uniformly distributed throughout the water. Therefore, sugar solution is an example for homogeneous mixture. Here, sugar and water, these are the two components, and they are mixed uniformly. We can't identify the two components physically. Whenever we see the sugar solution, we can't identify sugar and water separately. We will identify, or we will see only water, because in water these sugar molecules are uniformly distributed. Next, we will see one more example, that is salt solution. This is obtained when salt is dissolved in water. Here also same, we can't identify salt and water separately in salt solution. Whenever salt is dissolved in water, we'll see only water, because all like sugar molecules, this salt crystals are dissolved in water, and they are uniformly distributed throughout the water. Next, we will see filtered tea. Filtered tea is an example for the homogeneous mixture. This filtered tea, it has tea powder content, sugar, milk, or some of the people also add water. Okay, so this filtered tea consists of these four components: tea powder content, sugar, milk, water. Whenever we see the filtered tea, we will not absorb all these components separately. We will see only one kind of solution, or one kind of that is liquid we will see. We will not see the sugar crystals in filtered tea, because here sugar crystals, milk, water, tea powder content, they are uniformly mixed. So filtered tea is an example for homogeneous mixture. Next, we will see the air. Air consists of mixture of gases like nitrogen gas, oxygen gas, carbon dioxide gas, carbon monoxide gas, hydrogen gas, sulfur dioxide gas, etc. But in our surrounding, we are not absorbing the all these kind of gases separately. We can't identify all these gases in air. So because here all these gases, they are mixed uniformly. Therefore, in air, we can't identify the individual gases. Therefore, this air is an example for homogeneous mixture. Next, we will see alcohol in water. Whenever alcohol is added to water, alcohol is one component and water is another component. Whenever alcohol is added to water, we can't distinguish the alcohol and water after mixing, because alcohol and water mixes uniformly. These two components mixes uniformly. After mixing, we'll see only one component. Okay, we can't identify alcohol and water separately. Therefore, this is an example for the this alcohol in water is an example for the homogeneous mixture. Again, we will see one more example, that is soda water. Soda water, it consists of carbon dioxide and water. Soda water is obtained when this carbon dioxide gas is dissolved in the water. This is one component, and this is another component. whenever we see the soda water, we will not see carbon dioxide and water separately, because carbon dioxide is dissolved in water and it is distributed uniformly. These two components, they mixes uniformly. Therefore, we absorb only one component. We will not absorb both the components in soda water. So these are the examples for homogeneous mixture. In our daily life, we can find plenty of examples for homogeneous mixture. See what happens in case of homogeneous mixture. The components of the mixture are not physically distinct. In homogeneous mixture, we can't identify the individual compound. Why we are not unable to identify the individual component? Because here these two components mixes uniformly. When they mixes uniformly, they will form uniform mixture. So we can't identify the components of mixture physically, or components of the mixture are not physically distinct. Next, components cannot be seen by naked eyes. In homogeneous mixture, components which are mixed cannot be seen by naked eyes, because they are uniformly mixed and they are not visible to our naked eyes. All the components are not visible to our naked eyes, but can be seen with the help of the microscope. For example, if you take sugar solution, we can see only water with our naked eyes, but we can't see the sugar molecules with our naked eyes. But we can see both water and sugar molecules with the help of this microscope. Components of a mixture, homogeneous mixture, cannot be separated by any physical methods. Physical methods includes hand picking, sieving, filtration, etc. Okay. In case of homogeneous mixture, components of the mixture cannot be separated by any physical methods, but can be separated by chemical methods like evaporation, evaporation and condensation, chemical methods we can separate the components of the homogeneous mixture. Okay, children, now we will see what is heterogeneous mixture. A mixture in which different constituents or components are not mixed uniformly is known as heterogeneous mixture. The mixture in which different constituents or components are not mixed uniformly, then such mixture, they are not mixed uniformly, then such mixture is known as heterogeneous mixture. It means hetero means different. Here we can see the different components with our naked eyes. Therefore, heterogeneous, different mixture. Okay. Examples for the heterogeneous mixture: mixture of salt and sugar. If we mix salt and sugar in a bowl, we can easily identify salt and sugar by our naked eyes. They are physically distinct. We can see salt and sugar separately. We can see both these components. Mixture of salt and sand. Here also we can, these components are physically distinct. Mixture of grains and stone. And unfiltered tea. What happens in case of unfiltered tea? Milk, sugar and water. Okay, these three components, they are mixed uniformly. But what happens? Tea powder leaves. it is not mixed uniformly with all these three components. As a result, this tea powder leaves remains separately. This is one component. Okay, in case of unfiltered tea, all these three components are uniformly mixed and we can't identify all these three components. Okay, but we can identify this tea powder leaves because they are in the form of a solid. Okay, it is not uniformly mixed with these components. Hence, unfiltered tea is an example for heterogeneous mixture, whereas filtered tea is an example for homogeneous mixture. Next, we will see one more example, that is oil in water. If you mix any oil, it may be cooking oil, coconut oil, or castor oil, or even kerosene, petrol. If you mix this in water, if you mix these oils in water, they are not uniformly mixed. We will see the two separate layers. Water is at the bottom and oil layer is above the water layer. Whenever water and oil is mixed, they are not mixing uniformly. They will form two separate layers. Water is present or it is collected at the bottom of the beaker, but oil is present above the water layer. Okay. Reason for this is water density of water is greater than the density of the oil. Here, in case of heterogeneous mixture, components of the mixture are physically distinct. We can identify the two components of the mixture. See here, in case of mixture of salt and sugar, we can see both the components. They are physically distinct. They are physically visible. Components can be seen with our naked eyes. In case of this homogeneous heterogeneous mixture, components can be seen with our naked eyes. Components can be separated by physical methods. In case of heterogeneous mixture, because they are not uniformly mixed, because of this reason, they can be easily separated with the help of physical methods like hand picking, sieving, filtration. There is no need of chemical method to separate the components of the heterogeneous mixture. Let us see the differences between homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Children, see here, in one side I have written homogeneous mixture, in another side I have written heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture, it is a mixture in which different constituents or components are mixed uniformly. Okay. But in case of heterogeneous mixture, constituents are not mixed uniformly. Here, mixing of components are not uniform. Okay. Second difference is, in case of homogeneous mixture, their components are not physically distinct. They are not physically visible to our eyes. But in case of heterogeneous mixture, their components are physically distinct and they are visible to our eyes. Third difference is, in case of homogeneous mixture, the components or constituents cannot be easily seen with naked eyes. They cannot be seen with our naked eyes, but can be seen with microscope. Okay. But what happens in case of heterogeneous mixture? The constituents can be easily seen with our naked eyes. Okay. We will see the last difference. The components can be separated by physical methods. These components, in case of homogeneous mixture, cannot be separated by physical methods, but they can be separated by chemical methods. Okay. But what happens in case of heterogeneous mixture? Here, these heterogeneous components of the heterogeneous mixture can be separated by physical methods like hand picking, sieving, filtration, etc. Here there is no need of chemical method to separate the components of heterogeneous mixture. Examples for the homogeneous mixture are sugar solution, soda water, air, salt solution. We can also write plenty of examples we can found in our surrounding. Okay, examples for heterogeneous mixture are sugar and salt mixture, milk is also an example for the heterogeneous mixture, blood, mixture of grains and stones. Okay, children, in next class we will learn the types of solutions.